So I'm hoping that this angle is better. I have purchased a, I don't know what you call it, a stand. It's meant for your phone. You're supposed to put your phone or your tablet on there and attach it to your bed. I got it from Temu. And I'm just not using the stand that you're supposed to put your phone in. And there's like a little screw for like. It's kind of similar to a tripod. You just screw it on. So hopefully this will be a nice angle and you straight down and not at a funny angle. So I'm going to do the August Mission Inspiration. Step one, add a frame to the page. So this was a bit of an experiment. It kind of went wrong. I was trying to paint my doily black. And I thought if I do it on a piece of nice paper, I'll be left, it'll be like a mask. The mask part worked, but the doily kind of stuck and broke apart. So that bit didn't work, but this is going to make a lovely frame on the page. So we're going to attach that down. I'm just going to use some Elmer's glue for speed. And then we've got to decide what kind of napkins we want to use, or what is it? Tissue paper, maybe? Tissue paper or napkin fragments? I don't know. The interesting thing is going to be that if I add napkin or tissue paper, you're not going to really be able to see much because of the black. So, maybe we go with something else. Maybe some really thin paper. Have a look in my stash and see what we've got. Okay, so I found this wax paper that's got paint on it. I can just add a few bits of that. Good. I'm going to use some matte medium and a little spatula. Yeah. Look at some of these. It's a bit crusty. What shall we talk about? So my sewing videos have been doing really well. Thank you for watching those, if you've been watching them, and if you've enjoyed them. I think I'm going to do a short video very soon, where I want your guys' opinion on what I'm going to do next. So look out for that, or that might be out already, I'm not sure which order I'm going to do it in. Since it's a little short one, I might put it before this, I don't know. There we go. So, paint with a baby wipe is the next thing. And I may grab some gesso for that, so that we can make that background nice and cohesive, but we'll see when that dries. So I'll be back extremely shortly. Stenciling. Let's see. What should we go for? What a purpley colour, I think. Seedless preserves, maybe? Maybe a touch of that. Is that one wilted? Yeah, wilted violet. I've got these little stencils. And I didn't clean that one and now it's all stuck to there. There we go. Let's go for this. Right. I think I've been working on this for like 3-4 days now. So today is going to be the day we're going to finish it. And I'm going to get it up for you guys. This might just be see, but it'll be there. You can sort of see it on the edges here. That's where it's going to show up nicest. So, ooh, strong. Didn't expect that to be that strong. That's good. So yeah, it'll just be a bit of background interest. Nice, nice, nice. So a bit here. I'm okay to use the distress ink now because I don't plan on using any more wet medium. I hint of it up there if I can. Now then, stamping is the next thing. So do we go purple again, or do we do black? Let's do black. I'm just gonna grab. Let me grab this out so you can see which one I'm using. I'm gonna use this stamp set, the Professor. And we're not going for perfect impression. Very, very busy. Okay, just see. Stamp. Yeah. I'm just thinking. Maybe I need to do this on some paper. Let me see if I've got any. Tea dye paper. Give me a sec. Okay, this is going to be interesting to try. This is a paper bag that I've tea dyed. I think I'm going to try stamping him on there. And then we'll cut him out or tear him out. Get now using my stamping platform because it's a big stamper and it's just easier. I would highly recommend if you're just starting out or you've been crafting for a while, if you haven't got one of these, just get one. Mine is not an expensive branded one, it's just one that I found on the internet for fairly cheap, but it works and it's helpful. Problem with a big stamp is sometimes by the time you've got all of it covered, the first bit's dried. So you can do a little bit at a time. Let's just do the face area. This bag is not stamping very well. Okay. I think that is the best we're going to get. I knew I should have done this before. I should have taken this apart because this seam is interfering with the stamp. But that's good enough for me. That's fine. We've got the face. Just need that to dry a little bit. Stencil with ink, stamp around the page. Marks with a straight edge. So we can need that to dry for a minute. Marks with a straight edge. I don't really feel like getting any paint or anything out, so I'm going to do a very simple one second. There we go. Marks with a straight edge. Then I want face with as a focal image. So I think I am gonna take I don't think I'm going to add any glue to the center. paper to become transparent in the middle. There we go. It's lovely. Doodles and Zentangles. Doodles. I'm not really a doodler. So, let's just do doodle dots. And I think that will do. And then, do I find a quote? And stamp it onto here. Do I? I've got this visible image. Stop that. Let's pull out this again. Just open this up a little bit. Excuse me. Still recovering from quite a bad cough, so that might be enough. Yes. Ooh, it's a very sticky stamp. Oops. Good stamp. There we go. Okay. Now, So, today is the 10th of March, 24. And there we go. So, I hope you've enjoyed that video. It's a very chaotic background. But it's a fun page, I quite like it. In a weird way. So thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you again for the next one. Bye bye.